I get this question a lot. What should I do when my A/B test didn't perform the way I expected? Let's break down this question in two parts. First off, if you have run your test for 2 weeks, let's say, and if you expect it to have 95% statistical significance, but you have, let's say, only 82%, it's okay to run the test for one more week. If it makes it above 95% by the end of the extra week, and even better, if it stays there during the last 3 days of your experiment, great, you can conclude your test. If it doesn't, well, you will have to stop your experiment and evaluate it as inconclusive. That's usually a very tough decision because it feels like you were so close, but when you have only 80 or 85% statistical significance, the risk is too high that you will end up with a false positive. And the second part is, what happens if, like in the example in the previous video, at the end of your experiment, your success metric shows a neutral or worse result for your new version? The decision is much simpler in this case. You conclude your test and you say that your version B didn't beat version A, so you go forward with the original version A for now. Again, as Dave Pierre from Skyscanner said, an experiment is only a failure if you fail to learn. So even if you didn't bring in a winning new version this time, what you should do after the experiment is to try to understand the results you got. You can compare your test results to your initial qualitative research and data analysis results again, or you can even run new usability tests and data analysis to figure out the underlying reason behind your losing version B. The point is, try to learn and use that knowledge in your next experiments. And one more thing. Actually, neutral or losing A/B test results are not uncommon. Market benchmarks say that on average, only 1 out of 8 experiments end up with an actual winning new version. So don't worry if your experiment is among the other 7, just make sure that you learn from it. By the way, in my experience, if you do proper initial research by using the research framework I showed you, you can easily bring down the statistics from 1 out of 8 to 1 out of 3 or even 2 in your online business.